Hey there, I'm Cooper with Productive Robotics, and today we're going to look at a key piece of equipment for your robot installation. OB7 is extremely efficient, reducing downtime and boosting productivity, but there's a simple device that takes this robot automation all the way to the next level, allowing your OB7 to work with your equipment seamlessly and to do things that previously were not possible. Of course, this device is our GEI. Productive Robotics General Equipment Interface. At its core, the GEI is simply a black box which helps your machines and peripherals talk directly with the robot. But with this simple addition, you'll open up a whole new world of opportunities, whether you're using OB7 to deburr parts on a simple grinding wheel or to machine tend a complex multi-step job with one OB7 robot working between two CNC machines at the same time. The options are really unlimited. Straight up, GEI2 is designed as a plug-and-play unit with standard M12 connector. Now, it's the heart of our complete system of ready-to-go sensors and equipment. Everything is designed to work together effortlessly and obviously plug right in. It's fast, simple, and effective. The GEI2 features 24-volt operation and two optional 5-volt outputs with 8 assignable analog digital inputs and 8 outputs. Installation is quick and flexible. It has magnetic mounting feet that instantly lock the GEI in place on any steel surface. It's pretty cool. GEI2 is fused and contains an Ethernet port to connect to the robot, plus you can daisy chain together multiple GEIs for more complex installation. So every day our customers are actually using their GEI2 to help their machines better communicate with OB7 and to find ways to be more efficient, which streamlines their productions. And you know, while we're on the topic of efficiency, here's a great pro tip. OB7 is famous for being easy to move from one machine to another, but instead of transferring the wiring harnesses and peripherals, many users simply leave a GEI on each machine and then just have one plug to connect when moving OB7 to a new location. It's a great way to save time and also money. So how does this all work? Well, basically the I/O setup is done with the tablet, but first, plug the GEI into OB7 using the Ethernet to M12 cable. From the main screen on the tablet, then select the gears icon located in the top left corner of the screen. Now look for the I/O setup button at the top of the left side menu. First thing to do is name the setup that you're about to make. So tap the name box and a keyboard will appear for you. There, type in whatever the name of your setup is, and then tap anywhere else on the screen and the keyboard will disappear. Now below the name box, you'll see different I/O options. So scroll down to GEI2 and select the I/O ports that you want to assign tasks to. Note, to get there, we will scroll past the end of arm I/O screen. Yeah, OB7 conveniently does have multiple I/O ports built right in at the end of the arm. Couldn't be more convenient than that. But for now, let's continue to the GEI2 screen because this is where we'll start building our production cycle. So here we'll name the different inputs and outputs by simply typing in their name. So for example, for output number 1, let's call this cycle start. For output number 2, let's use this to blow off parts with the chip fan. So we'll type in fan.
Use input 1 for the finished signal from the CNC.
And say for input number 2, we might decide to have it open and close the machine door. So right here, we'll type in door to confirm when open. Now, a quick note here, GEI ports are normally off, shown in blue, but they can be easily reversed to normally on by clicking the on-off button, making them turn red. So, now back to what we were doing here. To continue, we will fill in a few of the different outputs that we're going to need for this project.
For output number 3,
we might decide to open and close the air vise, so we'll type in vise. Now, just continue down the list, assigning each function the sensors and signals and devices that your robot needs to do the job. Then use input ports for communication to the robot and output ports for things OB7 is going to operate or control. So you'll then plug in the appropriate peripherals. So, you know, air valves, relays, safety scanners, and any other equipment that you can get your hands on into their corresponding ports in the GEI2 using the M12 connectors. So for example, to control the air vise, we will plug the pneumatic valve into
output number 3,
and then connect the air lines from the valve to the vise. So likewise, to control the door and know its position, you'd plug the door limit switch into input number 2. The key here is that OB7 will work with the GEI to keep track of where all your hardware is and automatically coordinate their functions, so later when you're teaching and running the job. So your hardware now is ready, it's fast, and it's simple. The possibilities for you are really endless.